Winning a national championship doesn't happen overnight. It takes months of preparation and dedication. That's why we have to play hard, play smart, play disciplined, play together, and play and act like champions.
Here we go, together on three, one, two, three.
Together.
Eyes up. Get here. Move, move, cross, cross, go. Quick, quick, quick.
I was really excited just to get back with everyone and just ready to get the new players in and see how everything was gonna go for us. I just feel like we all know that the season ended how we didn't want it to end the season before, so we know we wanted to come in and work really, really hard so we could achieve our goals.
I worked on conditioning a lot close to the end of the season last year, and so coming into this year, I just wanted to make sure that I was in shape so that I can stay on the court longer and be able to run and help the team.
I already knew like what I was coming, bringing myself into a strong, like physical team. I know I'm happy to be strong physical. I mean, the workouts, I feel like the workouts would be harder than I expected. I mean, they were hard, but I got used to them and like understood like, all right, this is what I gotta do. This is where I gotta be to be where I wanna be at.
Let me tell you about this workout. So I'm just gonna put it like this. College, high school, two different things. You have to be in shape. You have to be on your P's and Q's. You gotta pay attention to the little details. You just have to be locked in and ready to go.
So this summer was a great summer for all of us, I think. Reaching each goal that we had with Maui, and then of course on the court as well.
Yeah, I think this year was a little bit different because we had such a big group coming back. We had essentially our entire team plus five newcomers. And so everybody for the most part knew what to expect and had felt that heartbreak of last year. And so I think the message from coach from the end of the season on was, we have to chase that 1%.
I love Molly. I mean, she's amazing. She demands so much out of us, and it's out of love and respect for our goals.
Molly's a different type of strength coach. I mean, she knows us individually. She knows our personalities, and you know, she knows when to, you know, be hard on us, and she knows when to just say, you know what, it's your day, you're okay, I understand.
You know, Final Four Fridays are really fun.
One, two, three,
it's fun to create, and it's fun to be a part of, I think, for our team, too. It's almost like a love-hate relationship, but my purpose with those days is try to get them outside of the weight room a little bit, get them to a different environment, expose them to things that are really hard, that are, you know, gonna be harder than what they have to do on the basketball court.
No, Final Four Friday, this is the version of the climb. Okay, it's the climb to the Final Four. Anyone have any idea how many miles it is from here to Target Center? in Minneapolis?
A lot,
at least 100. 100,
100 miles?
1,217 miles. 1,217 miles from this place right here to the Target Center in Minneapolis where the Final Four is. Okay? Everything today is about the climb. Everything today is about working together as a team, okay? There's a lot of things that it takes to get that mission accomplished of winning a national championship, and everything that it takes to get there is what it's going to take to get the mission accomplished today.
I think Molly pushed me in a lot of different ways, but mainly the Final Four Fridays. She had us doing really, really tough things, and one of the biggest things was like we couldn't stop doing one thing until we all as a team finished together. And I think that was really big because it kind of made me realize, like, now I'm on a team with a lot of good players. Like, I don't need to just individually think about myself. I need to work together as a team with my other teammates.
I think she emphasized a lot that, you know, it's only hard this one rep. So, you know, why not get it done? So I think it kind of refers to the court. You know, it's only, you know, one hard half. Let's get that done and, you know, get to the easier second half. So I think she definitely prepared me a lot mentally.
I'm on top of the world!
Before we, you know, we lock hands and hold hands every first day of practice for as long as I've been coaching, because it creates the circle that's needed for us to just have each other's back, sides, and fronts, because it's going to need that as we go down this journey of trying to do the things that we want to accomplish collectively as a team and individually, because it all has to work. It all has to work in that line, in that synergy. We all got to be working towards the same things, and when that doesn't take place, it can take away from our ultimate goal. If there's something going on this particular team that will prevent us from winning the championship, speak up. Here we go, y'all. You know, this is the circle that we form every year on the first day of practice, and we're joined hands. And we want to make sure that no matter how big this circle gets, because it can get big, right? Let's all just step back. With some of our players with the unfollows and the follows and all of that crap that means nothing in 10 years, you'll get stretched out. The most important thing is you don't let go. Don't let go. You handle the situation, okay? You handle it, and we move in, and our circle gets tighter. It's gonna have to get tighter and tighter and tighter as we continue on this journey of what we're trying to accomplish, okay? So we will bend a little bit, but just don't break. And these are your teammates. These are the people that's gonna be in your life forever, whether you believe it or not. 10 years down the line, you're gonna be able to call on the people in this circle, and they're gonna act like we're still at practice. We just practiced the other day, okay? So tighten up, my boy. Tighten up, my boy. So I say to us, I wish everyone the best of luck. Stay healthy, stay strong, mentally, physically, and spiritually, because you're gonna need it as we venture. It is not gonna be an easy task to do what we wanna do. We do what's in our hearts to do, but we around this circle can make it a lot easier. Okay, if we're true to ourselves. Find your truth. Find your truth. And that's you. Find your truth. So, God bless y'all.
Ooh, I was really tired. I remember I called my mom after the practice. I'm like, Mom, like, it's really hard. Like, this is my first practice, and this was so hard. I remember going into the practice, I was really excited. I was, you know, not knowing what to expect. Lord, we got into it, started doing the skills work. It just got harder and harder throughout the day. Really had to fight through it. And we did a lot of scrimmaging, my God.
Oh, I remember the first practice, I was very nervous. I was like, Lord, this is my first college practice. I remember talking to my mom, she was like, you got this. Just another day, another dollar. But I remember Molly was like, it's like, I'm getting money out the bank and taking some out the bank. And that stuck with me. So every little thing you do, you like get money out the bank.
As like I grew up in like my class, I kind of just want to like make sure that the freshmen and the younger people are like, they're good, you know? So when those first practices, they're no joke, and it's a lot, and it can be a lot mentally and physically on people. So just something I wanted to like make sure that I did was just like go around and just check on people, like hey, like, you're doing good, like it's all good. Like, you know, you're gonna make mistakes, but it's okay.
Yo, we can't give any gimmies. Sprint back.
During practice, you know, of course, we're a little out of breath, just a little bit. I mean, it's always like that, the first practice, first 3-hour practice, and it's a little shock to your body. But I feel like everybody handled it very well. And then after practice, we all were like just excited, like we finally did it. Like that first practice out of the way, it's time to get rolling.
Net worth came to us because it signifies so many different things. Obviously, the net signifies winning the national championship and winning championships and cutting that net down. And then the worth part of it is, you know, our fams really inject a lot of pride in supporting our program. Our players, they have NIL situation, so understanding their net worth, and then just our entire sport from a national standpoint, we don't always in the eyes of the national spotlight, we're not always seen as a sport. Like women's basketball isn't seen as a sport, so we just wanted to figure out a theme that will embody all of it.
I don't know about y'all, but I'm ready. I'm ready for the season, man.
Let's go, y'all. Let's get it. Let's go.
Exhibition game was really fun. Just being able to have the crowd back and really not in limited numbers, and everybody was welcome back, and just to hear them cheer for us and just be positive was a great start to the season.
I was really, really, really nervous. I remember that I was just really thinking to myself, you know, just go out there and play confident. But I just went out there, I'm like, God, like, all right, now I gotta remember this play. I gotta remember, you know, what to do here, what to do there, get a help side defense. Also, the fans were really like, it was just such a new environment because coming from high school, it was completely different. You could hear everybody, my God.
It was very exciting because last season I didn't get to have fans, so it was also, I was also very nervous to see all the people out there. But it was fun.
I think it was just crazy because it wasn't since, you know, my freshman year, I got to experience that. So, you know, to come back and especially our first game, they show up, you know, and they show out every single game. But just coming back and seeing that again is just, is amazing.
I feel like you could sense the anticipation from the fans, and it wasn't just us anticipating, you know, them being there, but them anticipating being there as well. It's just always an exciting moment when we're able to play in front of such a great fan base. And I feel like just that raised our game to a whole nother level, just having the crowd behind us and cheering us on.
It felt like my freshman year all over again. Just seeing the people in there, it was definitely like a shock. And it was just great, just like, what we have, you know, like season over, like that, it's so impressive. And we need that, and we'll just continue for the rest of the season.
First stop of the season, let's go.